Last year, the clarity of the water in Lake Tahoe was the best it has been since the 1980s. That's according to regular measurements taken by scientists at the UC Davis Tahoe Environmental Research Center. The visibility of the surface water last year averaged 71.7 feet. That is a really big improvement over last year, 2021, when the average visibility was at just 61 feet. But interestingly, at the start of last year, the lake was on track to have some of the worst clarity since the 1960s. But the last 5 months of the year averaged 80.6 feet of visibility. Dr. Jeff Schlatto says the return of a native plankton species called Daphnia is the likely reason for such a big turnaround. The microscopic organisms are very efficient at removing fine particles from the water.
What encouraged their reemergence was that their main predator, the mysis shrimp, had disappeared. And the reason for that is something we're still looking at. The main hypothesis now is some kind of fungal infection of what had been their primary food source.
And eventually the mysis shrimp, which you see here on the right, will return and feed on the Daphnia as before. Schlatto says this will probably lead to a future decline in water clarity, but not for another couple of years. The Tahoe Environmental Research Center has been taking clarity measurements since the 1960s, and until last year's big improvement with the return of Daphnia, clarity in the water hadn't dramatically worsened or improved over the last two decades. Dr. Schlatto says that this shows that efforts to limit the human impact on the Lake Tahoe Basin, while important, aren't enough on their own.
It was able to maintain the clarity, but not improve it. Now it seems that maybe an approach with working with the food web, or trying to encourage the right food web, plus these engineering solutions, may be, you know, the right step forward. But it's the next 2 years that will tell us that.
And I asked Dr. Schlatto how this year's enormous snowpack may affect water clarity now that runoff is really starting to increase. He says that while snowmelt naturally decreases the clarity a bit, even with a giant snowpack like this year, the incoming water is only going to account for about 0.3% of what's in Lake Tahoe. And that runoff is very cold, so it'll likely just sink to the bottom anyway. Back to you.